Previously, the central bank had condemned tax on mobile money as discriminative and contradicting efforts towards cashless transactions and generally financial inclusion. But in a U-turn by the Bank of Uganda governor, Professor Emmanuel Tumusiime Mutebile, State Minister for Planning David Bahati reported that they had reached a common position on the matter. The minister's statement to a parliamentary committee read as follows. This is now the final position of government. We are still standing by the tax measures and a reduction of mobile money tax from 1% to 0.5%. The Exercise Duty Amendment Act 2018, which brought in place the mobile money tax, was assented to by President Museveni and signed into law on June the 21st, 2018. But several MPs remain opposed to the tax.
We could have come with a reason to locate the basis, to use it as a basis to locate the argument that surely these taxes are needed now. But the truth of the matter is the reason is they gave for scrapping of the taxes, or rather not levying the taxes on the Ugandans. We're sounding and held a lot of substance.
We see people crying, businesses are closing. But at the end of the day, if it's cabinet that has tasked itself to renew contracts, to do what, I think we are going to see the common man who is duly represented in parliament miss out.
According to sections of the public, it is the commercial banks that are putting government on pressure to retain the tax for their fear of competition from telecoms that have invaded their space, reaching a point of offering loans.
These taxes came because of that competition, which is healthy competition of the financial institutions being out-competed by mobile money business. And the mobile money, unlike the banks which had failed to reach, even had to reach areas like Bruno, mobile money had gone further to those hard-to-reach areas.
When they first appeared before the committee, Bank of Uganda officials, alongside their counterparts from the telecom companies, noted that the tax was unpopular and that mobile money transactions had declined by 672 billion shillings in the first 2 weeks of implementation of the tax. The governor, who did not contradict the minister's position on the bill under discussion, further explained why there is no law to regulate the sector. He cited the Bank of Uganda Act 2000, which reads, Section 4, which stipulates the mandate of Bank of Uganda, is silent on the regulation and supervision of payment systems, including mobile money. He added that the provisions in the Financial Institutions Act also pose limitations on licensing of mobile money services, since the Act only applies to deposit-taking institutions. He suggested that a separate law was needed to regulate the mobile money sector. Lubege Manuel, reporting for Urban Television.